centered here, while here this one x, so this is an odd function. Psi 1 is an odd wave function. This was an even. Now I can plot psi 1 of x as well. So psi 1 of x will be, let me plot it here. Again, this is the axis, and in this we are having x, and here we are having psi, and now this will be psi 1. Now if I look here, two plots have been multiplied, means this is multiplied with the x. So the constant means the amplitude will be different, but our wave function will be somehow like this. Zero on the origin, because when x is equal to zero, it will touch here, and like this. Similarly, when I will come on the minus x side, then the value of psi 1 is becoming minus. So it's an odd function, and it will be somehow like this. The wave function will be like this. Similarly, I can plot the third wave function. This is x and this is psi, and now we are having this is psi 2. Now look to psi 2 here. We are having the Gaussian wave function multiplied with 1 and here x square. So what does it mean? That this is an even function. If I change the sign of x, the psi 2 sign is not changing. So this is an even function, and the plot of it will be, the plot of it will be like this, that I will have on these two sides, let me do some marking in order to plot it correctly, and we will have the same wave function, this one, psi naught, here. So let me plot it correctly. Like this. And similarly, this will be like this. And then, when x is equal to 0, we will have overall minus sign here in psi 2 of x. So at x equal to 0, it will go to the negative amplitude. So it will be something like this. So this will be an even function, because here I can see it is symmetric along x-axis, and the y-axis it is both sides the same. Here it's the same, so I can say that it's an even function. This one is an odd function. So we have plotted psi naught, psi 1, psi 2, and now we can check this one, that what will be the multiplication of these wave functions. For example, here psi naught, psi 2, similarly psi 4, similarly psi 6, they will be even functions. And psi 1, psi 3, psi 5, psi 7, they are all odd functions. So we start from an even function, Then we see an odd function, again even odd. So the states of harmonic oscillator are actually odd and even functions. Now if I multiply psi naught, if I multiply psi naught with psi 1, then it is even function and it is an odd function, and I do integrate this from minus infinity to plus infinity, then it will be psi naught conjugate psi 1 dx, and here it's an even function and it is odd function, and I will get in the even limits I will get 0. Similarly, if I multiply minus infinity to plus infinity psi 1 with psi 2 dx, then it will also be 0. Because this is an odd function, this is an even function, and we will get 0 there. But what if we multiply minus infinity to plus infinity psi naught with psi 2 dx? What will be the result? So psi naught multiplied with psi 2 are psi 2, psi 2 conjugate multiplied with psi naught, both will be equal to, I will have to put this value and I will have to put this value, and I will see that just sorting out all the constants, so psi naught conjugate will be equal to m omega over pi h bar and 1 over 4. This constant will multiply with this constant, which is 1 over 2 m omega over pi h bar 1 over 4, and then we have 2m omega over mx square minus 1, okay, so these are all constants, and then integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, 2m omega, this will be multiplied with this one, so this will come as it is in here, it will become 2 here, so 2 will cancel, and we will have 2m omega over h bar x square minus 1 and e to the power here minus m omega over h bar x square, only 2 will cancel. So this thing is equal, these two will multiply and this will give us 1 over 2, and 1 over 2 is here, so we will have m omega over pi h bar. So this 2 will also come here, and 1 over 2, and then we will have 2m omega over h bar integral from minus infinity to plus infinity and x square e to the power minus m omega over h bar x square, and then again this will be multiplied with this, so all this constant, but this constant will not come with this one, so I can write that here, and then we will write minus integral from minus infinity to plus infinity and e to the power minus m omega over h bar x square dx and the curly bracket. So we will utilize the previous integral as we have done here. We will utilize that integral here as well. So this one, okay, don't mix up this with this because it's part of this one. So we will have, when we do calculate, just calculate with the previous integration formula that we had, then we will get that integral from minus infinity to plus infinity psi naught conjugate psi 2 dx is also equal to 0. So this will also come out to be equal to 0. Now what if we are supposed to plot, instead of psi naught we are supposed to plot psi mod square, like psi naught mod square, the probability of it. Similarly, the probability of psi 2 mod square and the probability of this is psi 1, and here this probability of psi 2 mod square. So what it will be? When this one will be squared, so the only change which will occur, it will just increase a little bit here and then it will become a bit sharp. So the square means the square will be the same thing, but it will go a little up and it will become sharp. Similarly, this one will be the same, like more sharp here and a bit up than here, and the next one will become square, so it will also be like this. So let me increase it a little bit. So it will also come like this because it is now psi 1 mod square and it will always be positive. Similarly, this one, it will become a little bit more and sharp. Then this one, a little bit more and sharp. Similarly, this one will become plus because it is mod square. So it will go like this. And it will go a little bit like this and then like this. So we will have it like this.